Welcome to how to install and configure WireGuard VPN on Home Assistant. Settings. Add-ons. Add-ons Store. Home Assistant Community Add-ons. WireGuard. Install. Installation complete. Quick and easy. You configure before using. Server. I use a public IP address instead of a dynamic domain name. I will introduce how to use a dynamic domain name later. Copy. Paste. Save. Network. Port. 51820. You forward this port on the router. You set up a static IP address before forwarding the port. System. Network. Configure network interfaces. IP version 4. Static. Add DNS server. Google DNS. IP version 6. Disabled. Save. After completing the static IP assignment for Home Assistant, you forward the port on the router. Service name. WireGuard. Protocol. UDP. External port. 51820. You forward the same port that was set up on the WireGuard app. Internal IP address. Home Assistant. You forward the port 51820 to the static IP address gained for Home Assistant. On Home Assistant you install Samba Share. Install. Configuration. Password. 123. Username. Home Assistant. Password 123. Save. You use Samba Share to access folders on Home Assistant. Info. Enable Watchdog. Start Samba Share. Back. WireGuard. Enable Watchdog. Start WireGuard. On your computer you access shared folders. Home Assistant IP address. Username. Home Assistant. Password 123. OK. SSL. WireGuard. Hasio. QR code. You browse to the folder as above to find the QR code. This is the QR code for mobile devices using the WireGuard client application to establish a connection to the server. I use a phone that has the WireGuard application installed. Add. Scan from QR code. Import tunnel from QR code. Tunnel name. Create tunnel. Establish the connection VPN. There is traffic coming in and going out. I quickly completed a VPN with Home Assistant and allowed a phone to connect remotely. Next, I configured to allow a computer to connect remotely to the WireGuard server. IP address. I used the next IP address. I used an unused IP address. Public key. On the computer you installed the WireGuard Windows client. Add empty tunnel. Name. Home Assistant. Public key. You copy the public key. And add it to the configuration on Home Assistant. Allow types. Client allow types. This is the code for the computer to connect remotely. Save. On the computer you complete the configuration as follows. IP address. You configure the IP address the same as configured on the server. DNS. 8888. Peer. Public key. You find the WireGuard public key on Home Assistant. Log. Interface WireGuard 0. Public key. This is the public key of the server WireGuard. Copy the public key. Add it to the configuration on the computer. Endpoint. Home Assistant public address. Copy. Paste. Port. 51820. Allowed IPs. 00000. This is a basic configuration for a Windows client. Save. Info. Start WireGuard. From the computer I set up a VPN connection. Connected. There is incoming and outgoing traffic. So I have completed the WireGuard VPN setup between the Windows computer and Home Assistant. Finally, I introduce how to use dynamic domain names. You install DuckDNS. A dynamic domain name service used on many different platforms. Dynamic domain name services help solve the problem of dynamic public IP addresses. You create a new domain. Copy the domain name. Add it to Home Assistant. Token. Copy the token. Paste it into Home Assistant. Save. Info. Watchdog. Enable. Start DuckDNS. On WireGuard, you replace the IP address public by dynamic domain. Delete public IP address. Enter dynamic domain. Save. Restart. You restart WireGuard to apply the changes. I have completed the steps to install and configure WireGuard on Home Assistant. Thank you for watching. After completing the above steps, you use the domain name instead of the public IP address on the client applications. On the computer, you edit as follows. On the phone, you edit as follows. Good luck.